The Paramveer Chakra is India's highest military decoration, awarded for the highest degree of valor or self-sacrifice in the presence of the enemy. It can be and often has been awarded posthumously. The PVC was established on 26 January 1950 by the President of India, with effect from the 15th of August 1947. It can be awarded to officers or enlisted personnel from all branches of the Indian military. It is the second highest award of the Government of India after Bharat Ratna.
Following are the proud winners of Paramveer Chakra that describes the magnitude of bravery and determination along with multitudes of courage and selflessness.
Major Somnath Sharma, 4th Battalion, Kumaon Regiment. He took a very active part in directing the fire of his sections onto the ever-advancing enemies. His gallantry and tenacious defense was such that his men were inspired to fight the enemy. His last message to Brigade HQ received a few moments before he was killed. It was, "The enemy are only 50 yards from us. We are heavily outnumbered. We are under devastating fire. I shall not withdraw an inch but will fight to the last man and the last round." Lance Nayak Karam Singh, 1st Battalion, Sikh Regiment. The enemy launched 8 separate attacks that day. In one attack, the enemy managed to obtain a foothold in the platoon locality. Immediately, Lance Nayak Karam Singh, who was severely wounded by then, with a few men hurled himself in a counter-attack and evicted the enemy after a close quarter encounter, which accounted for many enemy dead having been dispatched by the bayonet. Lance Nayak Karam Singh proved himself to be a dauntless leader of men in crisis. Nothing could subdue him and no amount of fire or hardship could break his spirit. Lieutenant Rama Raghoba Rane, Corps of Engineers. On 8 April 1948, 2nd Lieutenant Rama Raghoba Rane, Bombay Engineers, was ordered to be in charge of the mine and roadblock clearing party at mile 26 on the Naushera Rajouri road, which passes through very hilly country. The enemy had the whole area covered with machine gun fire, but with superhuman efforts, in spite of having been wounded, with cool courage and exemplary leadership and complete disregard for personal life, he cleared the road, setting an example for courage and leadership. Nayak Jadunath Singh, 1st Battalion, Rajput Regiment. Nayak Jadunath Singh showed outstanding ability and valor of the highest order in action. By his complete disregard for his personal safety and example of coolness and courage, he encouraged his men to fight. His fire was so devastating that what looked like impending defeat was turned into a victory and the enemy retreated in chaos. Charging single-handedly at the advancing enemy, this non-commissioned officer performed the highest act of gallantry and self-sacrifice, and by doing so saved his section nay. His whole picket from being overrun by the enemy at the most critical stage in the battle of the defense of Naushera. Major Piru Singh Shekhawat, 6th Battalion, Rajputana Rifles. As Havildar Major Piru Singh emerged out of the second trench to charge on the enemy bunker, he was hit in the head by a bullet and was seen dropping on the edge of the enemy trench. There was an explosion in the trench which showed that his grenade had done its work. By then, Major Piru Singh's wounds had proved fatal. He had paid with his life for his singularly brave act, but he had left for the rest of his comrades a unique example of single-handed bravery and determined courage. Captain Gurubachchan Singh Salaria, 3rd Battalion, 1st Gorkha Rifles. Captain Salaria's personal example, utter disregard for personal safety and dauntless leadership, inspired his small but gallant force of 16 Gorkhas to hold on to their position, dominate the enemy and to inflict heavy casualties despite the enemy's superiority in numbers and tactical position. Captain Gurubachchan Singh Salaira's leadership, courage and unflinching devotion to duty and disregard for personal safety were in the best traditions of our army. Major Dhan Singh Thapa, 1st Battalion, 8th Gorkha Rifles. The Chinese attacked for the third time, now with tanks to support the infantry. Major Thapa got out of his trench and killed several of the enemy in hand-to-hand fighting before he was finally overpowered by Chinese soldiers. Major Thapa's cool courage, conspicuous fighting qualities and leadership were in the highest traditions of Indian Army. Subedar Joginder Singh, 1st Battalion, Sikh Regiment. Subedar Joginder Singh and the few men that were left in the position fixed bayonets and charged the advancing Chinese, bayoneting a number of them before he and his comrades were overpowered. Throughout his action, Subedar Joginder Singh displayed devotion to duty, inspiring leadership and bravery of the highest order. Major Shaitan Singh, 13th Battalion, Kumaon Regiment. Major Shaitan Singh dominated the scene of operations and moved at great personal risk from one platoon post to another, sustaining the morale of his hard-pressed platoon post. While doing so, he was seriously wounded but continued to encourage and lead his men, who, following his brave example, fought gallantly and inflicted heavy casualties on the enemy. Major Shaitan Singh's supreme courage, leadership and exemplary devotion to duty inspired his company to fight almost to the last man. Havildar Abdul Hamid, 4th Battalion, the Grenadiers. Havildar Abdul Hamid's brave action inspired his comrades to put up a gallant fight and to beat back the heavy tank assault by the enemy. His complete disregard for his personal safety during the operation and his sustained acts of bravery in the face of constant enemy fire were a shining example not only to his unit but also to the whole division and were in the highest traditions of the Indian Army. Ardeshir Burzorzi Tarapo, 17th Poona Horse. Though his own tank was hit several times, but despite the odds, he maintained his grit and determination and thereby allowed the supporting infantry to attack the enemy from the rear. Inspired by his leadership, the regiment fiercely attacked the enemy, heavy armor destroying approximately 60 enemy tanks at a cost of only 9 tank casualties. And when Lieutenant Colonel A.B. Tarapo was mortally wounded, the regiment continued to defy the enemy. The valor displayed by Lieutenant Colonel A.B. Tarapo in his heroic action, which lasted 6 days, was in keeping with the highest traditions of the Indian Army. Lance Naik Albert Ekka, 14th Battalion, Brigade of the Guards. Lance Naik Albert Ekka bayoneted the enemy soldiers who were firing and thus silenced the machine gun, saving further casualties to his company and ensuring the success of the attack. In this process, however, he received serious injuries and succumbed to them after the capture of the objective. In this action, Lance Naik Albert Ekka displayed the most conspicuous valor and determination and made the supreme sacrifice in the best traditions of the Indian Army. Nirmaljit Singh Sikon, No. 18 Squadron, Indian Air Force. In a fight at treetop height, he was eventually overcome by sheer weight of numbers. His aircraft crashed and he was killed, in thus sacrificing himself for the defense of Srinagar. Flying Officer Sikon achieved his object, for the enemy aircraft fled from the scene of the battle without pressing home their attack against the town and the airfield. His sublime heroism, supreme gallantry, flying skill and determination above and beyond the call of duty displayed by Flying Officer Sikon in the face of certain death set new heights to Air Force traditions. Lieutenant Arun Khetarpal, 17th Poona Horse. Second Lieutenant Arun Khetarpal was dead, but he had, by his intrepid valor, saved the day. The enemy was denied the breakthrough he was so desperately seeking. Not one enemy tank got through in the Battle of Basantar or Battle of Barapin. Second Lieutenant Arun Khetarpal had shown the best qualities of leadership, tenacity of purpose and the will to close in with the enemy. This was an act of courage and self-sacrifice for beyond the call of duty. Major Hoshiar Singh, 3rd Battalion, the Grenadiers. Major Hoshiar Singh, realizing the importance of machine gun fire, rushed to the machine gun pit and though seriously wounded himself, manned the gun, inflicting heavy casualties on the enemy. The attack was successfully repulsed and the enemy retreated, leaving behind 85 dead, including their commanding officer and three other officers. Though seriously wounded, Major Hoshiyar Singh refused to be evacuated till the ceasefire. Throughout this operation, Major Hoshiyar Singh displayed the most conspicuous gallantry, indomitable fighting spirit and leadership in the highest traditions of the Indian Army. Naib Subedar Bana Singh, 8th Battalion, Jammu and Kashmir Light Infantry. Naib Subedar Bana Singh volunteered to be a member of a task force constituted in June 1987 to clear an intrusion by an adversary in the Siachen Glacier, area at an altitude of 21,000 feet. The post was virtually an impregnable glacier fortress with ice walls 1,500 feet high on both sides. Naib Subedar Bana Singh led his men an extremely difficult and hazardous route. He inspired them by his indomitable courage and leadership. The brave Naib Subedar and his men crawled and closed in on the adversary, moving from trench to trench, lobbing hand grenades and charging with the bayonet. He cleared the post all intruders. NB Subedar Bana Singh displayed the most conspicuous gallantry and leadership under the most adverse conditions. Major Ramaswamy Parameshwaran, 8th Battalion, Mahar Regiment. On 25 November 1987, when Major Ramaswamy Parameshwaran was returning from search operation in Sri Lanka late at night, his column was ambushed by a group of militants. With cool presence of mind, he encircled the militants from the rear and charged into them, taking them completely surprised. During the hand-to-hand combat, a militant shot him in the chest. Undaunted, Major Parameshwaran snatched the rifle from the militant and shot him dead. Gravely wounded, he continued to give orders and inspired his command till he breathed his last. Five militants were killed and three rifles and two rocket launchers were recovered and the ambush was cleared. Major Ramaswamy Parameshwaran displayed the most conspicuous gallantry and thought nothing of dying at his post. Captain Manoj Kumar Pandey, 1st Battalion, 11th Gorkha Rifles. He was once injured on the shoulder and legs while clearing the third position. Undaunted and without caring for his grievous injuries, he continued to lead the assault on the fourth position, urging his men, and destroyed the same with a grenade, even as he got a fatal burst on his forehead. This singular daredevil act of Lieutenant Pandey provided the critical firm base for the companies, which finally led to capture of Kaluban. The officer, however, succumbed to his injuries. Captain Manoj Kumar Pandey thus displayed most conspicuous bravery, indomitable courage, outstanding leadership and devotion to duty, and made the supreme sacrifice in the highest traditions of the Indian Army. Grenadier Yogendra Singh Yadav, 18th Battalion, the Grenadiers. Despite multiple bullet injuries, he refused to be evacuated and continued the charge in the Kargil War. Inspired by his gallant act, the platoon charged on the other positions with renewed punch and captured Tiger Hill Top. Grenadier Yogendra Singh Yadav displayed the most conspicuous courage, indomitable gallantry, grit and determination under extreme adverse circumstances. Rifleman Sanjay Kumar, 13th Battalion, Jammu and Kashmir Rifles. Though bleeding from the bullet wounds, he continued the charge towards the bunker. In hand-to-hand fighting, he killed three enemy soldiers. He then picked up an enemy machine gun and crept towards the second enemy bunker. The enemy soldiers, taken completely by surprise, were killed by him as they fled their post. Inspired by his act, the rest of the platoon charged, assaulted the feature and captured Area Flat Top, an exceptional act of bravery and sacrifice. Captain Vikram Batra, 13th Battalion, Jammu and Kashmir Rifles. He single-handedly killed three enemy soldiers in close combat. He was seriously injured during this, but insisted on regrouping his men to continue with the mission. Inspired by the courage displayed by Captain Batra, the soldiers of 13th Jammu and Kashmir Rifles charged the enemy position and captured point 5140 at 3:30 a.m. on 20th June 1999. his company is credited with killing at least 8 Pakistani soldiers and recovering a heavy machine gun.
Only thing that can purchase freedom is blood. And today we say a little prayer of thanks to those who have sacrificed their lives for us.